Good morning, Grants Pass High School. This is your friendly administrator in the counseling office, Mr. Stillwell. Today, I'm going to share some information regarding requesting classes for next year. Your timeline for everyone, for all students, will be to finish and complete your requests by April 7th. If you're a junior, you'll be having a meeting or you've already had a meeting with your counselor to discuss your plans for next year. For 9th and 10th graders, you're going to log yourself into PowerSchool, select the class registration with a little pencil, and then select your classes. Your course catalog is online on the website. You go to the main page, find Counseling Careers and then Counseling Student Services. On the right side under Helpful Forms and Links, this is where you're going to find the new course catalog. New classes that you'll find in the course catalog for 22-23 start with Video Games as Literature. Mr. Kellogg has put this together. This is a 12th grade class. Mrs. Cuppy has brought back Theater Overview as a beginning level theater class. Mrs. Sorensen has proposed two new electives. Both require Gateway as a prerequisite. Sports Events and Entertainment Marketing Management will be offered next school year. Fashion Merchandising and Marketing Management will be offered the following school year for 23-24. Plan ahead. Mr. VA has proposed a classical guitar class offered for all grade levels. So you have some work to do. Go online, find the course catalog, do your homework. Talk to your teachers, not only about your core classes, but also electives. Their recommendations for you are due March 18th. And then finally, go in and select your classes by that study hall period on April 7th. Now, we have some videos that some of our elective teachers, our advanced classes, have put together to help show you what they have to offer. So, enjoy.
Hey everybody, Mr. Linderman here, letting you know about what's going on with computer science. We've got a little change coming next year with the introduction to computers course, and then we've got some old favorites like intermediate game programming, mobile app development, AP computer science principles, and AP computer science A. So if you have an interest in computers or just want to try out something new, talk with me or your counselor. Technology is always changing, and so are we.
Hi, welcome to the Grants Pass High School Art Room. This is a class for people that are passionate about art, but also a class for people that are interested in learning how to draw more realistically. If you're looking for a class that is relaxing and enjoyable, but also a place where you can learn a new skill, then this is a spot for you.
I'm Mr. Taylor, and I teach in the Digital Media Department. The first class in our program of study is Intro to Digital Media. This class is required to take any of our advanced classes in digital photography, video productions, or Beats 1. We also offer an advanced digital media class for anyone wishing to graduate with honors in CTE. I look forward to seeing you in class.
Hey there, I'm Julia Cuppy, and I'm the technical theater teacher here. And I want you to know a little bit about the class that you could actually take this fall. It's called Technical Theater 1. This class, you're going to learn all about costume and lights and sets and building and also prop making. So come check it out. It's a lot of fun, and we will be able to offer college credit in the future. So it'd be really awesome for you to learn practical skills that you can put right into a job out of high school. Hope to see you there.
Hi guys, it's Ms. Nye, health science teacher. I wanted to do a brief explanation on the CTE courses for health sciences because I know that there's a lot and it can get kind of confusing. We've got five courses, the first being emergency care. Shortened, it's called e-care. You're gonna learn everything for emergency medicine, CPR, first aid, how to work in a team for disaster response. It also has the opportunity to get dual college credit and BLS certified through AHA for those students who want to do that. So it's really cool. The second class is called Body Works. It's anatomy and physiology, a little bit watered down. So what the body is, how the body works, it's amazing. The third class is called Basic Medical Skills, and I teach you pathology, so that's disease process of the body, and additional medical skills, so blood pressure, heart rate, how to read a 4-lead ECG, how to test a blood sugar, really amazing skills that you're gonna need in your medical future if you go into healthcare. The fourth class is called Advanced Medical Skills, and it's just a bridge on the first one. It's more advanced skills. I teach you IV skills. I teach you how to place an airway breathing tube for somebody. I also put you in a hospital for not really an internship, but a clinical shift to follow a nurse, a doctor. We could also do dentists. We could do vet techs, kind of whatever you want to do. Attendance is really important, so you've got to be there. It's really cool. It's an advanced class, so it's usually for juniors and seniors. The last class is called Advanced Wilderness, and so that is everything healthcare outside of the clinical environment. So you're outside looking for supplies and how to use them and how to keep patients alive and maintain outside of the hospital. So all of these classes are amazing. We'd love to take you through all of them. If you don't know if you want a future in healthcare, just start with eCare. We have a lot of fun, and you're going to learn some amazing things that you could take with you for the rest of your life.
CNC router machines where we can carve wood and other plastic products.
So the last thing that we have in this class that's up for student use are these machines. These are molding machines. You go to SOLIDWORKS and you make a mold out of it, you put it there and you can put the plastic through there, and you can make molds of many different things. That's basically it.
I'm an engineer. I'm an engineer. From New York City to Santa Fe, San Francisco and St. John Bay, Kansas City to Abilene. I'm an engineer. I'm an engineer.
Algebra 2 or higher with a C or better, here are three reasons why you should take AP Statistics. Number one, you can earn 8 college credits through SOU. Number two, everything that we do in class is immediately applicable to a real life context. And number three, candy. See you next year.
Hey guys, I'm Mrs. McNulty. I teach AP Gov and Politics. It's a class that dives into the American political system and helps us understand what works, what doesn't work, and how everything in America is interconnected to our government. This class is worth credit at SOU. You can earn 4 credits of poli-sci, and it really feeds from like either the A-PUSH class or even just a regular US history class. I strongly encourage you, if you're college bound, to make sure that you're taking an AP class your senior year to make sure that you understand the rigor associated with a college level type course. So if you have any questions, please holler, but I would love for you to take the time to join me next year.
Hi, I'm Mr. Fry, and I teach Advanced World Cultures. If you are a freshman who has ambitions to go to college, you need this course. This class is not just about a deep dive into world history, although we will do that. We will look especially at the last 500 years of world history. We'll do a little bit of ancient stuff, a little bit of world religions, a little bit of art, a little bit of philosophy, a little bit of everything about the human experience. But it's also a great class to prepare you to be successful in lots of other AP courses. If it has anything to do with words or thinking or taking notes or schoolwork, this class is boot camp for the brain, and not just for sophomores that want to take AP classes, but for anybody that has a vision to go to college. I will help prepare you for that class. Is it a tough class? Eh, you gotta work at it, of course it is, but you're gonna get 2 free college credits, classes, 8 credits through RCC. Free college credits, that's a great deal. And we're gonna have a lot of fun. Lots of jokes, lots of silly stories. We will work hard, yes, but we will have a good time doing it, and we'll get you ready for your future. See you next year.
Another one.
I want to invite you to think about AP European History. It is a social studies elective, but it is also an AP class. In fact, you can get 2 courses of college credit by the AP exam. It's open to juniors and seniors. You don't have to have taken my class as a sophomore. If you are interested in European history and you're an AP kind of level student, or you want to be an AP level student, this class will prepare you to think, to read, to write, to do all the things you need to be successful in many college classes. And we're gonna do a deep dive into the last 500 years or so of AP Euro. So if you always wanted to talk about the psychology of Adolf Hitler, or whether Napoleon was really that short, or grimy little kids in the Industrial Revolution, or what's the deal with Putin anyway, this is a class where we'll get into all that good stuff while we are building our muscles to be successful college students. So if you're a junior or senior, you got room in your schedule, I'd love to see you in AP Euro. See you next year.
I'm Mr. Kennedy, I teach AP Physics, and I just asked my students, hey, why should we take AP Physics? And they gave me great answers. They said, flying chickens, Nerf guns, terrible jokes, and it's so exhilarating you'll stay up all night because you love it. These are good answers. I think you should take AP Physics because it prepares you for incredible jobs in the future, right? It's been shown that AP Physics prepares you for success on college applications, prepares you for success on the SATs. Just the type of thinking we do here works a muscle that you don't normally get to work. I think we also are going to be really, really, really well prepared for the AP test, and you guys are going to have the opportunity to get to college and look into careers in physics and engineering where everybody else is less prepared than you. So if you ever thought, I maybe want to be an engineer, you can lay the foundation right now and get yourself ready for a really well-paying job where you can go anywhere you want to go. So that and terrible jokes are great reasons to take my class.
Hi guys, my name is Kyle Swanson. I teach AP US History. The AP US History course at Grants Pass High School has 2 different ways that you can earn college credit. One is through the AP test. If you earn a score of 3, 4, or 5 on the AP test in the spring, colleges will award credit for that. We also offer credit through Southern Oregon University. You can earn up to 8 college credits through us at Southern Oregon University for the year of AP US History. You earn 4 credits in the first semester and 4 credits in the second semester.
Hi everyone, Mrs. McKay here. Just want to invite those of you in pre-calculus to take AP Calculus 1 next year. After taking AP Calculus 1, then you qualify to take AP Calculus 2 the following year.
A simile is a device that compares 2 things that do not seem alike. But unlike metaphors, which are almost the same, similes always use as or like. A theme is a message a writer puts in about how life is or should be. Personification is when things or animals have some human quality. Denotation is simple, a word's definition you'd find in a dictionary. Connotation goes deeper, it's ideas and feelings the word brings to mind, now you see. The mood is the atmosphere found in a text, like spooky or cheerful or doubtful. Tone is an attitude, writers.
So AP Environmental Science is a class you're looking at if you are interested in kind of getting a peek behind the veil of what happens in our world and in the environment. We study stuff like pollution and human impact on the environment. We do labs about 20% of the time. So every week we've got a different lab going on that's hands-on, that's exciting to do, and that explores some concept that has to do with, of course, environmental science. It's a fun class to take. If you have any questions, you can talk to me or ask some of the students in my class. They'll give you the lowdown on it.
In the end.